And I think what's most important is it has created also the misconception that Malaysia is all about Kuala Lumpur, Selangor, Penang. It's about cities, when actually Malaysia is actually also a vast, it's about rural areas, Sabah and Sarawak, which most people in the urban areas forget that they're also voters and they also carry a voice. And that also translates into the number of parliamentary seats that are up for grabs. And even though the urban areas have got more people, more voters, but they carry a smaller number of seats. And this misconception needs to be explained properly by my party, which the emphasis by my party, Barisan Nasional, is always about, it's always been about taking care of the rural areas instead of focusing on the urban areas where we are losing ground. We used to basically only lose ground in city areas. Now we're losing ground in suburban areas, and we've been pushed back to the rural areas. And therefore, we need to also refocus our election strategies and election methods to basically go back, and get back the suburban areas that we actually lost before. If this continues, if BN does not recognize this a new phenomenon, I think Malaysia will continue to be a divided country, the urban and rural divide, which is quite damaging for our economy and also our political process, because the Prime Minister's target or his wish to basically do a national reconciliation between races may not work, because the urban and rural divide also means that it's a divide between Malays in rural area and Chinese in the urban areas. Now, there are also other races in the urban areas, but in the rural areas is mainly the Malays and the Sabah people in Sabah and Sarawak. So this divide will still continue if Malaysian National is not able to bridge the gap, get back into the southern areas, and bridge the gap so that we can actually achieve some sort of national representation and national unity in the longer term. It's always been a party that's built a consensus before elections. Therefore, we are able to contest under one symbol. And therefore, our election strategy melts into one, for example. So people can't differentiate between problems within the component parties like MCA, MIC, Grakan, are they still around, but people can't. But when each of our component parties have a problem, the general voters cannot distinguish between UMNO and by the way, UMNO won 88 seats. UMNO had 3.2 million votes in this last election. So it's still the party that has the biggest number of votes. So they can't distinguish. So this last election was an MCA problem. It wasn't a Chinese problem as such, it was an MCA problem. The Chinese decided to move away from MCA to support the DAP. And the DAP did a good campaign. I'm not saying that it's racial, I'm just saying that they identified themselves more as a Chinese party, and therefore used that position, leveraged that position to pull the Chinese vote away from Barisan Nasional by hitting MCA.